Tonight, we're learning more about a child's murder and the case against his mother. In July of 2009, police found the badly decomposed body of 12-year-old Michael Bielitz in a bathtub at his home near 28th and Ida. Days later, prosecutors charged his mother, Angela Manns, with murder. But her attorneys say police never had probable cause to search her home in the first place. KATV News Watch 7's Ryan Luby is live with the latest.
That's right. Manns' attorneys hope to keep much of what police found at her home out of her upcoming murder trial. What they found and how they found it are details we're learning about through these search warrants, unsealed for the first time today.
July 2009, police go to a home near 28th and Ida. A neighbor tells them they had not seen or heard from Angela Manns and her 12-year-old son, Michael Bielitz, for more than a week. When they get there, they discover flies on the windows and, as they describe in court, an overpowering odor that required them to hold their breath. In a detailed affidavit, they say the foul odor was consistent with that of a decomposing body. So, officers stated they found an open window of the home and went inside. From there, they saw a discolored human foot sticking out from under a dark plastic cover in the bathroom tub. They later collected a lot of things, including, though, a pair of rubber gloves along with safety glasses, a box cutter, a knife, an axe, a sword, pieces of bone, and pieces of hair. Right around the same time, they say they saw Angela Manns' Dodge Stratus drive right past the scene, not stopping to see why officers were there. Turns out Manns was behind the wheel. They took her to police headquarters where she told them her son Michael was in Tennessee with her half-brother Jimmy. But a phone call to Jimmy revealed he hadn't seen Manns or her son since 2006. 2 days later, after that revelation, officers served another search warrant, this time in Manns' car. There, they found bags of kitty litter along with high-yield fertilizer. They also found a court summons document along with a letter from Child Protective Services.
Again, Angela Manns' attorneys hope to keep many of those details out of her trial. A continuation of today's hearing is set for later next week. Reporting live, I'm Ryan Luby, KETV News Watch 7.